Hi friends, it's Lindsay with Emeralds and Fairy Lights, and I'm here today for a post review. I'm going to show you this canvas that I just barely finished, and I love it. Look at this painting. This is called Evening Stroll by Deborah Malcolm, and isn't it gorgeous? Okay, we're going to do a quick look on this kit up close. This is Diamond Art Club's new diamond drills that they have. And can you see the shine, the shimmer in it? The shimmer is really just crazy. I mentioned this on my post review last week, but these new diamonds, when you set them down next to other diamond paintings, wow, the sparkle is just insane. I don't know how else to explain it. So I do have to say that I think that their diamonds at first appearance, when you're kind of shaking them in the tray, they look a little dull, which is not how they looked before. They looked more shiny. However, their new drills are more faceted. So when they're placed on your painting and you're looking at your painting in a painting in a whole, the shimmers are just insane. I do have to say that the diamonds are a little bit more pointy though, and you can definitely feel it when you put your hand on it or you like run your hand across the diamond paintings, that these drills are just a little bit more pointy. It's funny because the shine, I had a hard time taking a picture without these elephants just completely getting like the shine taking over the whole elephant. Other than that, I have to say this was just, you know, Diamond Art Club's usual standard of a diamond painting. They have impeccable quality, you know. That's why a lot of people just don't even do post reviews of Diamond Art Club, because they think, oh, well, it's like, you know, from technically, like, the canvas is awesome. You know, there's no fraying. The stickiness was great. The drills were pretty good, you know, or awesome, or the best on the market. And so, but I do still think it's really neat and fun to see these diamond paintings finished and what they look like, because I have noticed that the rendering doesn't always look like what the painting is actually going to look like. And a lot of times I actually like the rendering of the painting way more than I liked what their rendering looked like on the computer. I apologize if you can hear my laundry going in the back. You know, you just got to take advantage of any free time you have to film these videos. So as far as any changes that I made on this painting, I have to tell you that I did add these stripes. Anything I changed was basically in this bottom half, the water. I shook it there, I'm sorry. I just took these stripes in the water and I made them with ABs that matched the color that was charted. And so if that was either the direct same DMC number or something close, I just pulled out my colors and I looked to see one that matched closely. And I do like that, just because I think it adds extra sparkle and shine to this bottom area when you're looking at it in person. And it also makes this area stand out more from the sky, which are very similar coloring. And I think with the regular drills, you will get these lines, but it won't be as shiny or different unless if you don't like replace them with ABs. But I'm not saying that you have to at all, because there will still be the lines and there is still some ABs in the lines that they have included. Let's look at the drills. So the drills that we had quite a few ABs. And so you saw mostly this AB in the water that was included. And then there was also a bit of this AB in the water. So there were those two ABs. And then the third AB in this kit was this green AB. Oh, I'm sorry, and this pink. There was some pink too. And then this green AB, but the green was mostly up here in the trees. And I was a little worried that like the trees weren't gonna have very much green in them. But the way that they look, like after you've put all the drills in, even though the green is not, there's not a ton of green in there, you see the green. It's really pretty. So, yeah, guys, I just loved this one. And I had, like I said, I had plenty of drills left over. If you want to see, I really didn't replace very many of them because these lines are actually a lot of different colors mixed together. And so it was a little bit of a challenge to find all the little different colors, but I do have a lot of ABs just sitting around. And so I was able to kind of do it from this stash that I have. As far as the trash goes, I had this much. I do find that I find more trash in these new drill kits. I do find that they are more, they tend to have more holes in the top of them. And also I found, let's see. If you look at there's quite a bit of like the lines, or they have little things coming out on the side. I did find lots of little bitty pieces there, and then there was quite a few with holes on the top, which I find pretty common with acrylic drills. And so this was quite a bit of trash, I'll be honest, but for the most part, I think the drills were really, really good. I do think that I'm tending to find more trash in the round drills than I am in their new square drills. So for whatever reason, I don't know exactly, but that's just what I found. It didn't make the kit any worse for wear though, you know. As far as confetti and multi-placing, now this kit is, I would say, can be a multi-placing heaven in some ways, but it doesn't necessarily seem that way if you place horizontally. So I have recently switched over diamond painting from placing my drills horizontally on the canvas when I multi-place to doing it vertically. I find that when I place vertically, I end up with straighter drills overall. And I have less looking visible lines in my canvas. And if placing vertically up here at the top, this kit is just straight lines in order of the colors. If you look, and so you can do this really fast. I did this whole top of the canvas in 2 days, because it was just so relaxing and so easy to do. And honestly, this kit really only took me about 6 days to complete because it was just so lots of confetti. I mean, lots of color blocking if you are a vertical placer, is what I wanted to say, because this would be a little bit hard to, I think it would take longer if you multi-placed horizontally just because the lines don't add up. But I don't know, does that make a difference to you guys? Do you notice a difference when you multi-place horizontally versus vertically? Because for me, I really do find that placing vertically makes the canvas go actually a little faster, and also it keeps my drills a little bit more straight when I'm going. I have to tell you, the one thing that I absolutely adored and loved about this kit, and I sure hope that Diamond Art Club sticks with this sort of coating on their symbols, and I will show you a picture here. Okay, so I first noticed this about the symbols. In this kit, they have a white background, many of them, and they have different colors. It's not overwhelming, it doesn't distort the picture, but it really helps you differentiate the symbols easily. You have your dark purples to your blues, your greens, and so none of the colors really are next to each other and they mix. So when I was diamond painting this, I could easily know what color I was doing, and I didn't mix them up. It didn't confuse my brain because the symbols were similar. So on this one, you can see this even more up close, how you can see the C and the straight line and the T, they're all different colors in the white circle and easy to tell. And you can even tell over that the
the C is in black, but also the one is, but the one is on the pink square. And so everyone is different. Now coming over here, I'm showing you a different Diamond Art Club piece that is a newer one. And do you see how every one of the symbols are black on a pink with a circle? It's very hard to differentiate. You have an R, you have an 8, you have a 7, you have a 9. And all of those are written in black and are very hard to distinguish from each other without really straining your eyes. And it does kind of give me a headache. I found that the midnight or evening stroll painting was so much better for my eyes and for a relaxing diamond painting session.
Okay, so as far as this kit goes, that's just all I wanted to share with you. I just wanted to show you this diamond painting that is still available on Diamond Art Club. It's still in stock. It's gorgeous. What a fun painting and what a joyous painting in, you know, it's stressful times. And I think that this painting was one that really just the bright colors brought me a lot of joy. And I think Deborah Malcolm just painted a beautiful painting and Diamond Art Club rendered it beautifully. So let me know if you guys have any questions. I will see you guys in another video. Bye!